Kinetic studies of enzyme-catalyzed reactions are performed in order to calculate kinetic constants of the reactions, like Km, which is Michaelis constant, and Vmax, the maximum rate of the reaction attained using those fixed concentration of enzyme. So what we do in this, we basically take some fixed concentration of enzyme in a test tube, and we keep adding varying concentration. We make replicates. For example, you increase concentration from some value to another value of substrate. So you keep increasing substrate, and same time in that reaction you keep measuring rate of the reaction. Rate of reaction can be measured in different way depending on what kind of chemical enzyme reaction you are monitoring. So then what do? You plot substrate concentration on x-axis, and on y-axis you have rate of the reaction. So rate of the reaction is basically tells you about how much substrate, at what speed the reaction is progressing. So when you plot this, it follows Michaelis-Menten graph, which is hyperbola in nature. It means initially it is a straight line, the graph is a straight line, but after certain substrate concentration, the active site of enzymes gets saturated and it become almost constant. And where it become constant, this value of V is called Vmax, and half of the Vmax, half of the Vmax, the substrate giving half of the Vmax value, that is equal to Km, Michaelis constant, which is also give idea about affinity of that substrate to that enzyme. So basically in enzyme kinetics, the main objective is to calculate Km and Vmax for that enzyme catalyzed reaction. And if one is doing inhibitor studies, so the inhibitor can be added, and as a result of addition of inhibitor to the enzyme catalyzed reaction, how Km and Vmax are being changed, or at what affinity inhibitor is binding to the enzyme, that also can be calculated. But from this Michaelis-Menten equation, the precise calculation of Vmax and Km is not possible because this graph is hyperbola in nature. That's why there are different methods which are employed in order to calculate more precise value of Km and Vmax. And one of the methods is ED scattered plot. ED scattered equation can be derived from Michaelis-Menten equation only. So Michaelis-Menten equation can be rearranged. For example, this is Michaelis-Menten equation where V is equal to Vmax S divided by Km plus S. So the value of Vmax can be derived from this equation. Vmax is equal to KmV divided by Vmax divided by S plus Vs divided by S. So here S is common, so that can be removed. So the value of Vmax would be Vmax is equal to Km divided by S into V plus V. Now, in order to get Eddy Schedler equation, we need to divide this by Km. So Vmax by Km is equal to, when you will do Km here, Km will be removed again, so it will be V upon S plus V upon Km. Now this equation can be rearranged. And why do we rearrange equation? Because when we do enzyme catalyzed reaction, what we exactly do, we take some fixed concentration of enzyme, and then we can vary substrate concentration. And simultaneously with different substrate concentration, rate of reaction is measured. So what we have in enzyme catalyzed reaction is, we have rate of reaction and varying substrate concentration. So when you want to plot any enzyme catalyzed data, you need to arrange equation in such a manner that you can only plot V or S, or the similar V by S or S into V kind of numbers. So by dividing Michaelis-Menten equation with Km, we have got Vmax by Km divided by V upon S plus V upon Km. Now this can be rearranged. V by S can be taken other side, so V by S would be equal to minus 1 upon Km into V plus Vmax by Km. And this equation follows a straight line, Y is equal to Mx plus C. It means if you plot v upon s at y-axis and v, value of v at x-axis, the intercept on y-axis would be v max upon km, and it will be a straight line like this. So when you plot this, this is straight line. So this is the intercept at x-axis, which is equal to v max. Intercept at y-axis is equal to v max by km. So from this equation, you can derive more accurate values of v max and km. So now, how do you get these intercepts? Okay, so this is the Eddy Schedard equation. V upon S is equal to minus 1 upon km into V plus V max upon km. And because it follows straight line, so if on y-axis when you have V by S and x-axis you plot value of V, so the intercept at Cx, at the x-axis, y-axis would be V max upon km. So if you want to calculate values of intercept, what do you do? For example, on x-axis, at x-axis, if you remember, x-axis means v by s, the value on y-axis would be 0. So v by s would be 0. So you can put the same number, same value in this equation, Eddy Schedard equation. So when you replace v by s by 0, so v upon km would be equal to v max upon km. And similarly, v would be equal to v max. It means on x-axis, when the value of v upon s is 0, always remember this graph. So this is x-axis and this is y-axis. At y-axis you are having v upon s and this is only v. So here you have value of v by s 0. So if you want to calculate this intercept on x-axis, replace v by s by 0, and as a result, what do you get? The value of v would be v max. So that's why on x-axis this intercept would be v max. So value of v at the intercept will be equal to v max of the rate of v max of the enzyme catalyzed reaction. Similarly, if you want to calculate value of intercept on the x-axis, on x-axis the value of v is 0. So in this equation you can put value of v is 0 and then you see what you get. So on y-axis the value of v is 0 on the intercept. So you can replace the value of V0 in the equation, V with by the 0 number. So when you have 0 here, it means V upon S. V upon S is not 0. So V upon S is equal to 0 plus V max upon Km. So V upon S, the value of V upon S, which is plotted on the y-axis here, would be equal to V max upon Km. And intercept, this is also C intercept. So V max upon Km is the intercept on y axis. So value of V by S is here on y axis. So this value is equal to V max upon Km. So from this graph, you can calculate very precise, very accurate values of Km and V max in comparison to Michaelis-Menten equation.